Hello, I'm Ishwari, and I'll be offering Hatha tips for new experiences. Today, we will be talking about Ustrasana, the camel pose. Ideally, in camel pose, you'll want to prop under the knees. So you can use a blanket or you can roll the mat up, and you want the knees to be hips distance apart. So a great way to think about camel pose is to know that it's a back bend and it can be very intense. And there are many variations you can use to experience the benefits of camel pose without getting into the full extent of the pose. So if camel pose is new to you, you can use a chair from your kitchen or dining room. Want to make sure that there's a space for your legs to go. Propping up the knees for extra support, placing the feet under the chair. So the spine is long here. You can relax the hands on the side of the body and simply place the hands on the edge of the chair, or you can turn the hands so the fingers are facing the back wall, or you can have the fingers facing the body, whatever feels most comfortable here. And then from here, you can simply just begin to bend into the elbows, allowing the spine to relax back, keeping the neck loose and enjoying the benefits of camel, taking a few deep breaths in the pose, and then as if there's buoyancy in the heart, bringing the chest forward, moving the legs further away from the chair, and if it feels comfortable, sitting down and relaxing. And you can do that a few times as well. So you'll start with the torso up. You want the body to be long, or the spine to be long and the body to be relaxed. You can simply start by bringing the arms behind the body with the fingers on the lower back facing down. This is going to start to open up the chest, and you can begin to then bring the elbows together. From here, you can simply start to lower the hands on the butt, below the butt, on the back of the legs, and experience the benefits of this modified camel. You may realize that the gaze wants to start to look up, and if so, feel free to allow the neck to relax further. It's also great to use the use of blocks to help you get into the pose. So you can put the blocks on the inside or the outside of the feet, and with the arms either on the lower back or on the back of the legs. If you want to move further, you can simply place the hands on the blocks. Be mindful of the neck and spine here, and allow the gaze to look up. If you want to continue in camel pose, you can have the toes curled or the toes flat to the earth and take a hold of the heels. Ideally, the thighs are going to be parallel with the wall. As you continue to open the chest and shoulders, allowing the neck to relax. If it feels comfortable with the neck, you can actually allow the neck to relax completely back, so you're looking at the back wall. You can take a few deep breaths here, being mindful of the spine. And for more advanced practitioners, a way to explore this pose further is to place two hands on one foot or the other. And then to come out of the pose, you want to curl the chin in towards the chest. And imagine that there's a buoyancy in the heart. So from the heart, you're going to begin to pull the body up and back to the starting position. So even if you have the hands on the lower back, still imagine that the buoyancy is coming from the heart, bringing the body forward. When you finish practicing camel pose, you can simply place the hips towards the heels or place a block between the feet and sit back. So place the block between the feet, sit back, relax the hands on the thighs, close the eyes, feeling the sensations in the body. And if the back needs a bit more of a counter stretch, you can always come forward into child's pose. So these are the variations for camel pose. I hope you've enjoyed. We'll see you next time.